Big storms are on the horizon for most of the central and northeast regions this weekend. Please make sure your truck is well stocked with provisions and watch the weather. Do not drive into the teeth of the storms and park it off the roads if necessary. What up, gang? Y'all probably looking at me right now like, what the hell he got going on with them glasses on and the sunglasses up here? Y'all see it. See, what that is, I wear contacts as well. But my contacts been giving me problems the past couple days, so I took them out, put my glasses on. So that's why I got my glasses on. But I usually wear my contacts. And I need some new contacts, but guess what? For all my subscribers, you know, been watching my story, you know, I left my last job back in July. It's January now. So when I left that job, I didn't have any health insurance for a while. Now I gotta get my 90 days in with Melton before I get health insurance. So when I get some health insurance, I'll give me some new contacts. But until then, I gotta do what I gotta do. Gotta wear my glasses. Unless I put my contacts, I can put them in, but they just been irritating my eyes, so I had to let them soak for a little while. But you know, it's been a while since I did a ride alone. Last time I did one, when I was heading up to Washington, drop off those coils I had. So, since I'm out here, what's this? Texas 277, US 82. That's where I'm at now. 85 miles on this highway. I'm actually headed to the Melton Terminal in Oklahoma. That's where my fuel solution is at. So I'm headed there. I got like 5 hours to get there. I got like 8 hours on my clock. I got about 9 hours coming back tomorrow, then 9 hours coming back the day after that. So more than likely, I'm going to stay in Tulsa tonight. Once I get there and look at my route and all that, I see what I can work with. The load delivers on Monday. Today's Friday. So once I get to Tulsa, I have around a little over 700 miles left to get to Michigan. That's where I'm headed. So we'll see. 700. And I'm gonna try to get Michigan. I'll be there Sunday, but I'm gonna try to get there early enough where I can watch a football game. Kansas City, New England. I'm going for New England. I'm gonna try to get there. But since I'm on this straight stretch of highway, I just wanted to take the time to make this little ride along, talk to my subscribers a little bit, answer a couple questions, let y'all know how I've been going. I see a lot of other drivers doing their reviews 3 months in, 6 months in. So that's kind of basically what I'm gonna do right now, you know. I haven't quite hit 90 days yet. My 90 days is sometime next month in February. But the reason I'm doing it right now, a couple days ago, I got a message on the Qualcomm. It was like, congratulations, due to your hard work and, you know, stuff like that, you're being assigned to a permanent fleet. So as of this morning, I got my message from my new dispatcher. Now I'm assigned to a permanent fleet. I believe it's fleet 14, I believe. I'm not sure what it is, something like that. But now I'm in a permanent fleet. Is anything gonna change with being in a permanent fleet? I asked my old dispatcher that. He was like, nah, not really. He was just like, you're not gonna be able to get the dispatcher on the phone as much. That's what he told me. I don't know myself what's gonna happen with that, because my old dispatcher, he's a pretty good guy. Y'all might have heard me talk about my old dispatcher a lot, you know. Man, he's a good guy. And didn't, hey, he's sarcastic. I'm sarcastic as well, but it's all love, though. He does his job, I do mine. So I haven't actually had a conversation with my new dispatcher. I don't have a need to, you know. I got my load information I need, so that's all I need to do is get this load there by Monday morning. At the beginning of this video, I put a little clip up there about driving into the snowstorm. My third time going into some winter weather down in Texas right now, and it was 59 degrees. Well, the highest I actually got up to down here in Texas, I hit like 81 one day. It was like 81. Yesterday when I was securing my load down in El Paso, it was actually pretty warm out there. It was about 80 degrees then. So I made two White World videos, White World Part 1, White World Part 2. Part 2 wasn't as good as the first one, in my opinion. But I got a feeling, man, just from seeing this stuff on the news, and I keep getting messages on my phone about this winter storm Harvey. Seems like it's gonna be pretty bad. And I tell you this, I haven't ran into a situation where I had to shut it down because it was just too bad for me to drive that I had to shut it down. But I was reading my message. I showed you a little clip. I didn't read out. Well, I don't even know if I seen it up there. I think I might have seen it online when I Googled it. It's supposed to be a pretty bad storm. It's supposed to drop up to 40 inches of snow. Snow plows might not be able to keep up with it off the highways. You know, that's the thing about the snow, man. As long as those snow plows, as long as they keep it off the interstate, you know, you good. When you get on those back roads, that's when you got issues. So as long as they keep it off the highway, you know, everything be all right. So, yeah, we'll see about that. I guess I'll probably start seeing snow. It's supposed to come in tonight, but I'll be in Oklahoma. Probably shouldn't be too bad. Once I start going further north, once I get out of Kansas, I'll see how it goes from there. I do have to run through Kansas again. My advice to all the new drivers, take it easy in that snow, man. Don't get out there trying to speed. If you get into a situation where you feel like you can't drive, you know, you just gotta shut it down. Me myself, I haven't ran into that predicament where I had to shut it down. Only thing I did was I just slowed it down. Slowed it down, ran about 45, 50, 35 if you got to. Guy messaged me on Facebook this morning, asked me about how I cook on the road and stuff like that. Basically, man, I eat canned chicken. I like the canned chicken because, you know, you can just pop the top and eat it. And it's healthy, it doesn't have a lot of calories. I need to lose a little weight. So yeah, I'll eat some of that canned chicken. I got canned vegetables, I'll eat that. If I have time, I actually heat it up. But most of the times, I just open it up and I eat it. You know, it's already pre-cooked, you can eat it. That's what I do. I got some canned tuna. If I want to eat, but I really don't like canned tuna too much because, you know, for it to taste really good, you gotta put salt and stuff on it. I'm trying to cut back on the salt, so. Probably won't be eating too much more of that. I just think it's canned chicken. Some of y'all may be like, well, you know how you can eat canned chicken all the time. You know how I can do that? Because I'm humble. You know, I'm not too picky. As long as it serves its purpose, it feeds me. That's pretty much what it does. Truck stop hot dogs. Eat a lot of those. I need to cut back on those, but you know, stop at the truck stop, get your fuel. Stop there, take a 30-minute break, you know. Two hot dogs, like $3. I mean, hell. Like this other guy, old trucker, told me, it takes the hanks off. Y'all ever heard that phrase? Just enough to take the hanks off. So that's pretty much how I survive on the road. And I get that canned chicken, I get it from Walmart. Last time I got some, I got it from Dollar General. But most time I get it from Walmart, because Walmart, you can get it a little cheaper. You can get more for less money. podcast. Appreciate all my subscribers checking in. I think I got about 112 right now. Got about 112. It's going up. Appreciate y'all subscribing. You know, my lawyer subscribers. I can tell who the lawyers are because, you know, y'all comment all the time. And most of the time, you know, I answer back. Got nothing else to do. Back there in my sleeper berth. Got nothing else to do, man. Get on YouTube and watch Truck and Truth. I watch that a lot. I really don't do nothing else but watch YouTube. Watch YouTube, watch Facebook videos. That's about it. Make YouTube videos. I enjoy doing that because it's fun. And, you know, I'll show y'all some pretty good footage. I got my GoPro now, so, you know, footage, maybe it's going to get a little better. We'll see about that. Good thing about me going to Tulsa, I got to do some laundry. I did some laundry a couple days ago. And I pretty much wasted my time and money. I stopped at a Petro. I had white clothes, I had colored clothes. I put them in separate washers. It was $3 a piece for each one. But when I dried them, I put them all in the same dryer. So the washers, it was $3 for 30 minutes. I put them in the dryer, it was $6 for 60 minutes. So I put them all in the same dryer. I sat at that Petro. Those 30 minutes for them to wash, 60 minutes for them to dry. So that's about 90 minutes, give or take. A little more than 90 minutes, you know, it takes time for me to get there and walk around and all that. So maybe about 2 hours I stayed at that Petro. Guess what? Took them out the dryer. Clothes were still wet. I was like, good Lord. 60 minutes. And these clothes, I ain't talking about a little damp. I'm talking about wet. Even the small pieces, like that should have been, I can understand, you know, the jeans, stuff like that. But little small pieces like t-shirts and underwear, it's no reason. Those 60 minutes, they still should have been damp. I'm talking about like so damp, like I can squeeze water out of them. But, you know, I still had like 90 miles to go before I got to my, I didn't know that they had overnight parking at the place I was delivering to until I got there the next morning. I looked at it, I was like, you know what, I could have stayed here. But I didn't get it on my route suggestion that they had overnight parking. So whenever I'm not told they have overnight parking, you know, so most of the time I don't take the chance to go there because I tried that one time before. And when I got there, somebody came out there and told me, they was like, you can't park here. So I was like, okay. So I had to leave. So luckily down in San Angelo, you can park at the Walmart. If you check it out on Trucker Path, you can see that you can't park there. But the Walmart was only like 5 miles up the road from where I was dropping at. So yeah. I didn't have time to put them back in the dryer for another 60 minutes. And so I just kept it moving. I said, I just have to rewash them. So now I'm going to Tulsa. And that's another reason I probably know I'm going to stay tonight there. Because I'm definitely going to do my laundry. I'm going to wash everything all over. And Tulsa's washers and dryers, man, those things on point, man. Tulsa, Birmingham, they got those old school industrial size washer and dryers. I'm talking about, man, they don't even take long, but hey. Don't use the ones in Tulsa in the new building, use the old ones. Man, those things get the job done, man. Friday night, I don't know how many other drivers are gonna be there. But I'm washing everything. Everything, washing it, I'm washing my sheets, washing my comforter, I'm washing it. So yeah, let me get back to the point of this video, man. 90 day review, but like I said, it ain't been quite 90 days. But since I'm already added to my permanent fleet, I'm gonna go ahead and get my review of Melton. Melton Truck Lines, my opinion, just like I told the guy that gave me his phone number earlier, if you are a new trucker, if you never had a truck driving job, you're looking for a company to get a start with, Melton, man, you, man, you look on the internet, you Google it, you do your research, man, you're really not gonna find nothing bad about melting on the internet. You might find some bad stuff, but the stuff you find is gonna be like so off the wall stuff, like for people that like basically what it comes down to, you know, it's that person's fault. It's not Melton's fault. Yeah, Melton is a good company, man. I love it. I love this company. You might hear me talk a little junk on my videos, but that's nothing, man. You're gonna deal with that. Yeah, I started out at 43 cents a mile. 90 days, I go up to 45 cents. With my hazmat pay, whenever I pull a hazmat load, I get an extra 3 cents. So yeah, man, that'll be 48 cents. I've already pulled a hazmat load already. When I go home on my next home time, which is gonna be like 2 more weeks, I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna get my passport, I'm gonna get my TWIC card. I'm gonna go ahead and get that stuff. Then maybe I can let y'all know about that. Maybe if I go to Canada or if I get a load out of the ports. But that stuff you need, man. Your TWIC card, your passport, your hazmat. That stuff you need, because you know Melton, a lot of guys stay here at Melton for years. I don't know what I'm gonna do, because I got aspirations of owning my own truck one day. I know a lot of guys, you know, they talk bad about the lease purchase and all that. I mean, from what I understand, you know, that stuff is what you make it, man. That stuff is what you make it. I know guys that do lease purchases, they make good money. As long as you pay your tax, you gotta make sure you pay your taxes. That's the first thing. Pay your taxes. I had a couple tax issues years ago with me not paying enough of my taxes. And guess what happens? You're not gonna run from that tax stuff, man. You're not gonna run from it. One day you're gonna go to the a burger restaurant, and that's what happened to me. You're gonna go to a burger restaurant, you're gonna try to buy your burger, $10 burger. You know you got money in your bank account. You know you got enough money to buy this burger. You're gonna go to that burger restaurant, you're gonna swipe your debit card, guess what's gonna happen? The lady gonna swipe it, she gonna swipe it like 2-3 times, she gonna look at you, she gonna say, sir, the card is being declined. I was like, man, my car's been declined. I was like, man, so take out another car, pay for it, bam, stay for it. So you go sit down while you're waiting on your burger, open up your app, man, what's going on with my bank account? You look at your bank account, you see them three letters, IRS, IRS, they will get you, man. You cannot run from taxes. I seen a quote a while back, says, it's two things in life that are certain, taxes and death. I'm 32. I'll be 33 in February. And I've already had an issue with paying taxes. I didn't understand the tax thing. I was like, you know what? I got a job. You know, I pay taxes. They take taxes out of my check every week. Every week they take taxes out. I'm like, how do I owe taxes? But see what it was, man. I was paying taxes, but I wasn't paying enough taxes. So I had to go change my change a little dependence and all that stuff. Had to change that stuff. So yeah, man, I'm getting killed on taxes. I don't have any kids, so I don't have any dependents to claim on my taxes. So yeah, man, I pay taxes out the ass, and I never really get anything back. Never, like every year, I never really get anything back. So I'm like, yeah, taxes is crazy, man. It's a crazy situation. Pay taxes. Everybody else getting these big checks back. You go up there, find out how much you get. Sir, you owe $180. Well, oh, you might get $180 from the state. No, not the state, but from the federal, but you gotta pay the state some money, whatever. But that's when I was going to Jackson Hewitt. Last year, I went to a tax professional, and I had been going to Jackson Hewitt for years. But I found out, you know, they don't really try to help, you know, they just filing it. You go to an actual tax professional, you know, that's when they actually comb over your stuff. Try to figure that stuff out. So yeah, make sure you get a, y'all younger truckers coming in, you know, that's advice for y'all. Your older people, y'all might know a little better. Yeah, but that's something I figured out myself. Get you a tax professional. Don't go to Jackson Hewitt or what's the other one? H&R Block. Don't go to them. They're not gonna help you. They're just gonna put numbers in, bam, 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 out of here. Next person. So yeah, man, back off to Texas. Yeah, Melton's a good company, man. when you're in the developmental fleet like I was, they don't dispatch you no different than they dispatch the other drivers. So just because you're in the developmental fleet don't mean nothing. You're running the same miles as everybody else. A lot of people be asking me, how many miles do you run a week? The most I ever ran in 1 week was 4,100. And I see what that, I had one load that was 2,500 miles, and then the other one was like 1,600. And the only reason I know that I got that was like that, because it was going into the new year. So, you know, like, everything was closed on New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, everything was closed. So I basically had like 2 extra days to get the load there. Most loads deliver on Monday, and maybe like Friday, like Thursday or Friday. So yeah, I had like 5 or 6 days to get that load there. That's when I made that video, White World Part 1. I was up and driving through the blizzard in Wyoming and Utah. But yeah, this week actually, I think I ran like 2,700. This week is gonna be about 2,700. Yeah, man, I want to run like 3,000, 3,500. It'd be nice if I could get that every week, but I ended up getting stuck down here in Texas. No freight. Deadhead 400 miles from San Angelo to El Paso to pick this load up. So, yeah, I guess it just all depends on the market you're in. Y'all hear my buzzer going off? Yeah, that buzzer's something else, man. Hey, the guy that commented on my video said a truck is a truck when I was talking about the Freightliner. No, man, a truck is not a truck. Every truck is different. You got Kenworths, you got Freightliners, you got Macs, you got Volvos. Every truck is different, in my opinion. I like the features in the Kenworth better. Maybe the brand new Freightliners, you know, they got better features. So no, a truck is not a truck. This is a Freightliner. I talked about some of my issues I had with it early on. You know, those are my issues in my own opinion. I mean, that's no right or wrong. You know, this truck does what it does need to do. It gets me, it makes me money. I don't have an issue with this truck. You know, I was just talking about the simple issues that I didn't like with the Jake brake and the cruise control. You know, I figured out how to use it pretty good now. I mean, you can't set the cruise if you got the Jake set. You can't do it. What you can do, once you get your cruise running, then you can use your Jake brake while the cruise is on. You can do that. But you can't set it while you got the Jake brake on. You got to cut the Jake off. And if you have to use it, you know, just flip it down and use it. A couple other issues I have with this truck. You know, I just started really making the good money. So, you know, before, you know, I really wasn't spending any money on getting myself comfortable in here. But now, so I'm making a little money. Last week, I was at a Petro up in Pennsylvania. I stopped at a Petro. I decided to get me a CB. I didn't have a CB. So I stopped to get one. I was so happy about buying that CB. I was telling my buddy Shaq over there at Swift. I always talk about him. I was talking to him. I said, yeah, man, I'm gonna buy me a CB. I think I might need one, you know, out riding in the snow and all this stuff. So I was so happy about that CB. I went in there, I bought my CB, came back to the truck. There's a CB shop at the Petro. The guy was telling me, drive around there, you know, talk to them people and all that. Maybe they can help you out. And I went over there to the guy, and the guy was telling me it was $16 an hour to install it. You know, I'm thinking you just plug it up, that's it, you know. But I was like, the guy was like, it was like a 2 hour wait. I was like, no, I can't wait 2 hours. Good thing I did, because I talked to my dispatcher a little later and I was asking him about it, because what I found out, the guy was telling me I didn't need anybody to hook it up for me. I could do it myself. He was like, basically you just, what he said, the hot wire, the ground wire, that's all he was telling me. So I was like, okay, I can do it myself. So I get back to the truck. I'm looking around the truck, you know, guess what? I'm about to hit the Jake right now. Go around this curve. Y'all hear it? But the cruise is still set. I just hit the Jake. All right, that's good. Now I'm gonna cut it off. Cruise kicks right back on. That's how you use the Jake and the cruise at the same time. So anyway, I look all over the truck. In the Kenworth, got the CB mount up top. All you gotta do is plug it up. I'm looking around my truck. Guess what? I don't have a CB mount. I'm like, mother flipper. I'm gonna try to stop cussing on these videos. I was like, man, I don't have a CB mount. So now, I got a CB. I don't have a CB mount. I took it back. Never took it out the box. Took it back in there. Got a refund. Another issue that I've had from the jump with this truck. Small issue. I wouldn't say it's too small, but it's an issue because I don't have time to do much cooking anyway. My refrigerator doesn't work. I need to let somebody know that when I get to Tulsa. If I make it there before everything closes, before that, I don't know what time that inspection bay closes. My refrigerator doesn't work. I really can't keep any food. Any food that has to be cold, I can't keep it in here. My refrigerator doesn't work. But that's a small issue. I mean, it's not too big of a deal. I never even said anything about it. It doesn't work. Maybe when I get there, I let them tell somebody. Maybe they can check it out or something. But if they don't, you know, I'm not worried about it. You gotta look past the small stuff, people. Look past the small stuff. As a new driver, if you need a company to start you out at, would I recommend Melton? 150%. I recommend Melton. They got the highest pay. You're gonna run over the road now. I've been to LA, I've been to Washington, I've been to Massachusetts, I've been to Miami, I've been all over the country. You're gonna run some miles, man. Man, but that's just something you got to do, man. You got to suck it up. You got to suck it up. You got to run the miles. Because you know why? You're a brand new driver. Nobody else is going to hire you because you don't have any experience. That's what you got to do, man. That's basically what it comes down to. I'm trying to think of anything else I can tell y'all, man. I pretty much answered most of my comments on YouTube. People ask me a question. Yeah, man, y'all see me. Y'all see me from the jump, you know. I always keep a positive attitude. Anybody comes up here, you know, wants to talk junk about Melton, whatever, you know, I'm not even going to entertain it. I'm just going to erase the comment. I'm not going to respond back because, you know, I'm doing what I got to do to make myself a better person. And that's it is what it is. How many times y'all heard me say that? It is what it is. Got a buddy over there at Pam. I've been telling him I'm going flatbed for the longest. Keeps talking about he's not really making any money. But now I talked to him last night. He's saying he's about to go to US Express. He's about to check them out. So best of luck with that. Yeah. Some people, man. Hey, but for me, man, I love flatbed. I'm not gonna say I'm not gonna do something. As of right now, you know, I like doing it. I like getting out. I like securing my loads. I like just, you know, I'm from the country. This type of work doesn't bother me. Jumping up and down on that trailer, throwing chains, throwing straps, you know, getting dirty, that don't bother me. I've been working my whole life. I am about as humble as homeless can get. And I'm grateful for the opportunity to work for this company. 57 more miles on this highway. I'm actually on US 82. So 57 more miles, I'm gonna get on. It's basically gonna be the same highway. That's all it's gonna be. It's just gonna be a different name. 318 miles before I get to Tulsa. According to my Google Maps, let's check it out real quick. According to it, I'll be in Tulsa at 3:31 p.m. But I'm gonna just go ahead and add 30 minutes to that because, you know, I'm driving a truck. I'm not running 75 or 80 like a car. So I say I'll be there at 4 o'clock if I don't stop. But 300, yeah, I will stop one more time and do a load check. When I get down about 160 miles, I stop to do a load check. And this load I got right now, man, it's actually those chains, they don't loosen up like straps do. Those straps, they kind of work their way loose a little bit. You might gotta bind them a couple times. But those chains, they do a pretty good job of staying in place. So basically what I do on that, I just reach my hand up under the tarp and I shake it a little bit just to see if it moves. And I've already done it. You're supposed to do it every 150 miles. I mean, I do it whenever I just feel like doing it. If I hit a couple spots in the road where like a bridges and stuff like that, got potholes and stuff like that, if I hit some stuff like that, I'll pull over whenever I get it. I'm not gonna say like right away, but whenever I run into a situation like that, you know, I always go with my gut instinct. I want to check that load to make sure that it ain't loose. Because that happened to me one time before. I was down in St. Matthews, South Carolina. I was about 10 miles from where I had to drop the load off at. And I went over some railroad tracks. And I slowed down before I got to them. Because for me looking at them, you know, it was those railroad tracks. You know, sometimes when you go over the highway, you know, like they got them like down in the road, but this time they were actually like raised up on the road. So I seen that they were sticking up. So I was like, you know what? I can't hit those going 55 miles an hour. I gotta slow down. So I slowed down about 25, 30 miles an hour before I went across them. And I still, man, I was shaking like, I was like, this is going across. I was shaking. I was like, man, they need to do something about the railroad tracks. And, When I kept going, and when I got to my drop, I went back to the back, and I had slinkies up there. And when I got to the back, one of my straps, it actually came really loose from bouncing on those tracks like that. And like it didn't take much for me to pull it out. And I was like, yeah, you know what? You know you gotta watch stuff like that when you hit those bumps. You know, just take a few minutes. Check those straps out. Straps, chains, whatever you got. Like right now, I'm hitting some bumps. Those ain't that bad. Yeah, but those chains I got on here, man, I got them pretty tight too. Y'all see in my little video, when I got loaded, well, when I secured it, you know, when you pull that chain binder down, when I was in orientation, you know, the guy said, you know, when you pull it down, you want it to be like 90 degrees once you pull it down. Like if you can pull it further than 90 degrees, like you pull it down like 45 degrees, you need to move it up a length. You need to move it up a little bit. When you got it down there to like 90 degrees, that's a pretty good position before you put your bar on it. And you put that bar on it, yeah, you gotta put a little work in it. You gotta put a little work. And after you get all your chains or straps or whatever up there, you know, when you do your first two within the first 5 feet, first and the last 5 feet, you know, see what happens with that one. And you put every one down, you need to go back and double check. Because, you know, the more straps, the more chains you put on, the lower that load is getting. So the chains or the straps that you put on in the beginning, when you put all the rest of them, you know, you pull that load down a little more. So you need to go back and double check the ones that you did at first. Because I had to do that too. I had to move one of my binders up a length because it was pretty loose. If you can shake it like that, it ain't tight. You gotta get those chains where they're solid, man. They're solid. Chains versus straps. Which one do I prefer? Let's see, that's a hard one. That's a hard one, man. It's some work getting those chains out of that chain box. Like yesterday when I got them out, a lot of my chains had fell down into the bottom. And you know, you get one chain on top of the other one, you gotta take some work to get those things up out of there. I mean, yeah, it don't really matter. It don't really matter to me. The chain, but like I said, the chains, they don't loosen up as much as the straps do. If y'all see my video from yesterday, and from El Paso, you might see on the video that I have straps over the tarp. Melting, I mean, I'm not gonna say they don't or whatever, but you know, they don't train you like that to put the straps over the tarp. Some drivers do it, but the reason I did it is because those chains, they can hold it, they can hold it pretty good. But you know, since I know I'm going up in this snow, and I never know what's gonna happen, I just felt like I needed a little bit of more extra security. So I threw two straps over the over those tarps, just for my peace of mind. That's why they're up there. They're not up there to hold the tarp down, because I got the bungees on the tarp. They're up there pretty good. But I just put those two straps over that tarp just for my own peace of mind, just to make sure I'm holding it a little better. That's why they're up there. So, Melton, my review, that's a good company. You a new driver? Don't be scared of flatbed, man. Don't be scared of it. It's fun. Y'all see this country I'm riding in? Ain't nothing but grass. Texas, still in Texas. Texas is a big state, man. I was leaving out of El Paso. I seen the sign for Dallas when I left out of El Paso. It was almost 600 miles. And that's in the same state. It's a pretty long way, man. So I hope this video, you know, sheds a little light on this company. Giving y'all, telling y'all how I feel about the company. So I like making these videos because I like to document my journey. When I get old, you know. Hey, YouTube, you know, it's probably still gonna be around. This is my journey. And I like sharing it with y'all because, like I said in another video, I watch other YouTube truckers as well. I like watching their interviews. It's fun, man. It's fun to me. It's fun for me to make these videos. It's fun for me to put my message out to y'all. You know, hopefully inspire y'all to do what y'all gotta do. Become successful truckers. That's what I'm doing, man. So I'm pretty much gonna wrap it up. 5-star review. I'm gonna give Melton 6 stars. 10 out of 10. I'm gonna give him 15. It's a good company. So if you're watching this video, you wanna know if Melton is a company for you, I'm gonna go ahead and tell you. If you're a brand new driver, if you already driving and you got experience and you can pretty much go anywhere else, you know, that's up to y'all. Y'all can do what y'all want. But for the new drivers that just came out of CDL school, if you're looking for a good start to your career, this is where it's at. All right, people. All right, I've already killed this cup of coffee. Hey, another tip I'm gonna give y'all. If you like coffee, I'm gonna tell y'all this. Never turn down a free cup of coffee. Never turn it down. You go to one of these shippers, one of these co-signees, sometimes you gotta wait. Sometimes you gotta wait in line, or sometimes anything can happen. A lot of times they're gonna offer you some coffee. You're a coffee drinker like me? Never turn down a free cup. I was in El Paso yesterday talking with another Melton driver. And he was making some coffee. I made the first pot. Because these terminals, you know, they got coffee. Hey, drink all the coffee you want. Yeah, I had made the first pot, and he showed up. And I was about to go back and get me some more coffee. And he was in line, and he was like, go ahead, man, I'm going to make some more. I was like, all right. And I that's when I told him that. I said, yeah, man. He offered it to me. I said, yeah, man, you can never turn down free coffee. He said, tell me about it. He said, I drink coffee 24/7. I said, me too. I said, when I'm at home and I'm drinking coffee 9, 10 o'clock at night before it's time to go to bed, my girlfriend be like, why you drinking coffee? You're not going to bed? I'm like, yeah. I'm like, yeah, I just like to drink coffee. It's relaxing. I did a little study on coffee one time, me, my girlfriend, and my sister-in-law. We had a little debate one day, and telling my girlfriend, me and her teamed up against my girlfriend, Googled it and was telling her all the benefits of coffee. coffee can help prevent cancer. It can improve your mood. It can help stimulate you, you know, stimulate your system. Hey, coffee got a lot of benefits to it. The cons of drinking coffee, if you drink too much, you will have to use the bathroom. If you're like me, man, you have to pull over, take a quick bathroom break. This video on this note: drink lots of coffee, stay safe on the highway, drink coffee, stay safe, everything else will work itself out. Thanks for tuning in, man. It's a 40-minute video. Y'all know a lot of y'all might not have time to watch this, but what y'all can do is like what I do when I'm riding in my truck, my phone hooked up to the radio. I just listen to the videos on YouTube. Just listen. You don't gotta watch it, just listen. So while you're riding in your truck, you don't got nothing else to do, just put this video on play. Let it play. Check me out, man. Thanks for tuning in.